Hey guys, I'm Molly Ewing, YouTube videographer at Global Social Media Marketing. In last week's Google Ads course video, I went over some key terms and definitions you need to know before diving into Google Ads. In today's Google Ads tutorial, I'll be showing you around Google Ads and going over the Google Ads campaign structure. So, let's get started.
So, before we get started, some things you need to consider before creating your ads are: what are the goals for trying to advertise on Google? Are you trying to get your brand out there to gain awareness? Are you trying to get sales and conversions? Or are you trying to generate leads? And then you also want to plan for your campaign. So some questions you want to think about are: who is your target audience? You know, who is the main demographic that you are marketing your ad towards? And then you need to ask yourself what your budget is, because this can determine how long you will be able to run your campaigns for. You also need to determine ad creative and content. So you need to figure out if you're going to be creating, you know, text ads or videos or in-stream ads. And then you also need to identify target landing pages. So just to review what a landing page is a little bit, that is the link that you provide in your ad that you want the customers to land on. So it could be, if you're a business, it could be your homepage. It could be the homepage for your company. Or, you know, if you're trying to promote a certain product or service, it could be a tab within your company website specifically for that product and service. So next we're going to talk about the structure of Google Ads and a Google Ads campaign. So Google Ads is organized into three layers: accounts, campaigns, and ad groups. Your account is associated with a unique email address, password, and billing information. For more details on this, you can watch our How to Create a Google Ads Account video, where we walk you through that process step by step. In today's video, we will be focusing on campaigns and ad groups in Google Ads. Campaigns have their own budget and settings that determine where your ads appear, and your ad groups contain a set of similar ads and keywords. To give you a better idea of how Google Ads is organized, we are going to take a closer look at these two layers on a Google Ads account. So, let's hop on over to Google Ads. So, now that we're over in Google, the first layer that we are going to be talking about is campaigns. So the first thing you need to do is go over to this menu bar on the left and select campaigns. And as you can see, a list of campaigns will pop up. And what you can do is, if you look above that list, there's a filter and you can select whether you want to view all of your campaigns, all of your enabled campaigns, or all but your removed campaigns. And this just depends on what you want to look for in your campaigns and your personal preferences. So to review a little, a campaign is a set of ad groups that share a budget, location targeting, and other settings. Campaigns are often used to organize categories of products or services that you offer. And as you can see, your Google Ads account can have one or many ad campaigns running at once. Each campaign consists of one or more ad groups, and some settings that you can set at the campaign level include budget, location, language, distribution for the Google network, and more. So one thing to keep in mind is that your campaign is your marketing goal. So if you want to get leads or you want sales or conversions, then that would be your campaign. So if you look over here, you can see that this campaign wants to maximize conversions. And same with this campaign, it wants to maximize conversions as well, or you have manual CPV, you can target CPA or maximize clicks. So it really just depends on your campaign type, what you're wanting to accomplish with that ad campaign. So if I click on a campaign, it will bring me into an ad group. An ad group contains one or more ads that share similar targets. So ad groups are essentially buckets of groups that are your target audience that could be related to multiple factors. So you could look at it from demographic, such as age, gender, or household income, or an ad group could be adjusted to keywords. So it really just depends on what specifically you're targeting your ad for and how specific you want to get with it. So each one of your campaigns is made up of one or more ad groups, and you can use ad groups to organize your ads by a common theme. For instance, you can separate ad groups into the different product or service types you offer.
So if you click on this ad group, you can see the multiple different keywords that are used for it. And if I want to look at this ad and what it does, I'm going to click on Ads and Extensions, and then if I click on this right here, I can see a preview of what it would look like in Google. So this is an example of a Google search ad, and this shows you exactly what it would look like. So as you can see right here, we have the headline of the ad, and then we also have, you know, the description and the callouts and the landing page linked. So to let you look at the link and the landing page of this ad, we're going to go back to here and I'm going to click on this. So this is the landing page for this ad, and what this ad wants to do specifically is it wants you to, you know, say you search for insurance leads on Google and you click on that ad and you get led here. The goal is hopefully to get you to click on this green button. It's nice and bright. So you click on it and then you'll be redirected to this page and you fill out a form. And once you click submit, you'll be redirected to a thank you page. And I'm gonna go back over to Google Ads. So as you can see, these two ads are different. This one is generate insurance leads. This one is Facebook marketing. So the headlines are different and the keywords are different,
but they are measuring the same thing. They both want you to click on the link and fill out the form and then be redirected to the thank you page. And the thank you page has Google tracking code on it, which will fire and populate inside Google Ads as a conversion. So the purpose of putting these two ads in the same ad group is to test them against each other to see which will outperform so that we can run the winner more. And to start off in any ad group, it is recommended that you run a minimum of 3 ads in order to test which one works best. Okay, and the next thing we're going to talk about is keywords. So to do that, I'm going to go over to this menu bar on the left again and select keywords. And keywords, while they're not part of the main 3 layers, they are a very important part once you get into, you know, creating campaigns and ad groups. They're an important part of making sure that your ad has good visibility. So what keywords do is they target audiences searching for things similar to or related to your ads. So by adding keywords to your ads, you are optimizing them in your ad to match them to the same keywords people are searching for. And this gives your ad a greater chance of being seen. So when you go into Google Ads and click on the keywords, you can see the success rate of the keywords and how they're working. And one thing to keep in mind with keywords is you want to try and think like the consumer that you are marketing towards. So the next thing we're going to talk about is ad position and ad rank. And ad position is the order in which your ad appears on a page in relation to other ads. For example, an ad position of 1 means that your ad has the highest position on the page relative to other ads of the same type. And the ad position is determined by a formula called ad rank. Ad rank gives your ad a score based on your bid, the quality of your ad, and landing page. The quality of your ads can be determined by things such as if the keyword is the same in the description of your ad as it is for what people are searching. If you do have a keyword for your ad that you are targeting, then you want to try and put that keyword into your description somehow to keep everything consistent and help the consumer journey as much as possible. Because if they type in that keyword and that keyword appears in your ad, then A, you're going to have a much higher chance of having good visibility and ranking higher with your ad, but B, you're also going to help out that consumer's journey a lot more by having exactly what they search for. And lastly, we are going to go over AdWords and best practices. So you always want to have a landing page that matches your ads. This will help your ad quality and click-through rate. High volume campaigns should be combined with landing page tests. So if you're going to be doing different campaigns, you're going to want to test different landing pages and see what works, because certain things might work better than others. And if you are running several different ad campaigns at once, why not try to optimize that and figure out what's working and what's not? You also want to profile your customer to see what keywords work and what they are searching for. And this goes along with, you know, making sure that you're optimizing your ads and what you're putting in your ads, but also making sure that the customer experience is as easy as possible. And lastly, the importance of a landing page is often overlooked, but you know, you want to make sure that your keyword, text ad, and landing page are in sync for an overall better user experience, because as I mentioned before, this just keeps everything consistent. If the user is typing in the same keyword phrase that it appears in your ad, and then your ad takes them to your landing page, which is exactly what they're looking for, has all the keywords, and you know, has exactly what they typed in and what they were searching for, then that's going to A, help your ad and get you the sales or clicks or whatever the purpose of your ad campaign was. That's going to get you where you want to be, and it's also going to help with the customer experience.
So, now that we've gone over the Google Ads campaign structure, we're ready to create a campaign. So stay tuned for next week's video on how to create a Google Ads campaign. Thanks for watching, and remember to give us a like and subscribe below.